everybody, it is Friday. Welcome to Win or Fail Friday. My name is Amy, Dream Flight 6000, and today we are making candy corn swirl cookies, and this is from the Simple Sweet Life's blog. So let's get baking. You need 2 sticks of butter, a cup of sugar, a teaspoon of vanilla extract, a teaspoon of baking powder, 2.5 cups of flour, and an egg, and food coloring. All right, so I mixed up the dough, which was simple to do, didn't take very long. The dough is a little more crumbly than I would have expected, so we'll see. You could always add a little less flour, I suppose. So I have I divided it into 3 equal little sections, and I'm going to leave one of them just the way it is, and I'm going to add orange dye to this one and yellow dye to this one. Okay, so that was way easier than I thought. I just used this food coloring, just the basic food coloring, and then I used red and yellow to make orange. So I have my yellow, I have my white, and I have my orange. So I'm going to put these in the refrigerator to firm them up for about 15 to 20 minutes. And then we're going to roll them out. So I rolled all 3 colors out, the orange, the plain color, and the yellow, and now I'm about to stack them. Now in the directions, or in the blog post, it said that you should have them 1/2 inch thick, which is not possible because I would have no cookies. So I just made it really teeny teeny, just a little, real thin each one. So it must have been a misprint, or maybe they didn't know about measurements. I managed to stack them all, and it looks so tiny. Hers looks gigantic on her picture, so I don't know. So anyway, so I'm going to take my rolling pin, and I'm going to roll it to make it, like, bigger. And then I'm going to use the pizza cutter, like she said, and just trim up the sides. And then I'm going to roll it up and put it in saran wrap and put it in the fridge and go with it. Okay, so that actually worked. So rolling them all together seemed to work way better. So it's a nice size now. It looks more like hers. All right, pizza cutter time. Okay, so I actually used a plastic knife because I didn't want to scratch my counter. So now I'm going to roll it, and hopefully it's not stuck to my counter. Look at that. I did it. Look at it. I did pretty good. All right, now we're going to wrap it in saran wrap and put it in the fridge. And I think she said 40 minutes in the fridge. All right, so this is the inside of it. It looks really, really nice. It cuts great. I just used a knife. They said on the blog to use like some thin thread, but I think the thread wouldn't work, I don't think. I think this knife works really awesome. And this is what they look like. She again said to use 1/2 inch, and I started cutting 1/2 inch, and it's way, way too thick. So I actually cut it 1/2 of that. So I just cut a little cookie like what I would think, and I hope they are good. I'm going to put them in the oven at 350. And we will see. Here they are, everybody. They turned out really, really nice. They actually look almost like they're from a can, you know, like you buy them at the store already pre-made. But they are homemade. Look how pretty they are. You know how I trimmed the sides? I actually rolled all the leftovers up into a roll, and I wrapped it in the saran wrap too. And then I just made it into a log and cut little cookies out of that. These are tiny little cookies, so I'm going to actually cook those also because I think they're pretty and they go with the rest of them. All right. So as far as taste goes, I didn't tell you much detail about them. They're good. They don't really have a ton of flavor though. They almost taste kind of floury, if that makes sense. Just not a ton of flavor. I don't know. But they aren't bad. I already ate 3 of them, so you can tell. I mean, they're not bad, but they're not amazing either. So, all right. But I'm still giving this a win because of the concept of it. And you could really do this with anything in different colors for different holidays and birthday parties or whatever. I think it's really an awesome idea. Turned out really pretty. Definitely would make these again. I would just use my own sugar cookie recipe next time. So very, very fun. Definitely a win.